shark has such teeth, dead, and it shows them.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Lisa Sparks, you know her?
Mm-mm.
No.
Mm-mm.
Okay, I got to think you probably watched all these films. She starred in Leave It to Cleavage, Open Up and Say Ah, Thanks for the Memories,
yeah.
Dude, I Banged Your Mother 5. There were four before she got in there. Feed Me Some Cum and Paste My Face.
Wow.
You don't know those?
I like her already.
Oh, I knew you would. But that's not the best. There's more. She had, Lisa Sparks once again, had intercourse with 919 men in one day, setting a new record in 2004.
I
figured you would know.
The
I figured.
Thing. Yep.
Yeah. Now, that's a lot of guys. And I think I did the math. I think it's like 37 an hour, something around there.
Okay.
Well, how do you think they did that?
I'm well versed in this topic.
Well, that's why I figured you'd know who she was.
I should have known. Well, they got the fluffers going, so you pretty much have like your 30 seconds, and if you're not, you know, it's all about getting in, and if you don't go, you're out. Like,
okay, but if you go in 30 seconds, you get to go.
And then it counts. But I think if you go, and I think you have to finish before it actually counts.
Okay.
But they
really?
Yeah. And so you pretty much stand in line. They get you ready, and like you're up, and you go, and if you make it, congratulations. If not, you're out.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'd have no fucking problem.
I don't know. That's a lot of pressure. I don't know if I could perform under those conditions.
I don't know me either, but I think when push came to shove,
yeah,
I think I'd have no problem in 30 seconds.
If I remember, she's pretty hot, right? Like
she's not
like
bad.
Yeah.
She's not bad. She's bigger,
mm-hmm.
But she's not bad. Mm-hmm. She's not bad. Okay. Enough about Lisa Sparks. If you want to set the, for you women viewers out there, you want to set the all-time record, you got to get through 920 in 24 hours. And what do you call them? The fluffers?
Yeah, you could get a couple friends to do the fluffing.
Yeah, record. Okay, yeah. Okay. Yeah, that would be pretty fun too. You know, they do
you just go for the fluff. They don't have to even participate.
Right. Well, with me, I'd probably be done with the fluff. Okay, welcome. This is episode 46 of Pittsburgh Dive Bar Talk. I'm going to talk a little bit real quick again about our website. The question this week for the second week is three artists or bands that you didn't like quite as much as most people did, the general populace did. And I'm not even going to talk about the results. And this is kind of what I figured.
Mm-hmm.
There's a bunch of different groups. There's not a lot of the same. There's how many artists and groups are there in the world?
Right.
So you don't expect one person to win, you know. But you go on there, you have a chance to win a T-shirt. Shelly won the T-shirt this week.
Nice.
Did she get it? You never hear from her?
I have not heard.
So maybe she didn't get it.
Right.
I don't know for sure.
Don't know.
You go to our website. We have some new pictures up. Have you seen that?
I haven't.
No.
Mm-mm.
Geez, you don't go to the website very often.
No, that's not true. It's been a busy week.
Okay. Well, anyway, got some new photos up of yours truly. And like I said, you can go and answer that question and have a chance to win a T-shirt for this next week. You can learn about beer. Did I tell you Miller wants to come on here live?
You
now.
Did. We have a standing line now.
We
for
do.
People who
we
come
do.
On.
And I don't know if I told Miller was going to bring some beers up and we were going to test them on live
oh, I
on
like
air.
That.
Yeah,
I like that.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think I have a situation worked out where we can all sit. I
sit mean, right
it
here.
It might look a little funny with as you know we always get intimate with each other, but
and Miller's not a small man either. You know him?
Oh, yeah. He's been to beer.
Okay,
night.
That's what I thought. Yeah. That's what I thought. Yeah, he's not small, so. Well, we'll do
we'll
it.
Make it work
we'll,
for the
we'll,
show.
We'll get it done. Yeah. We'll get it done.
We have to back the camera up a little bit to fit us in the.
Yeah, about 45 feet. And one thing that we haven't talked about, we didn't have a production meeting this week. Although I sent you some stuff.
I'm prepared this week.
Okay, good. Our living legends of Pittsburgh Dive Bar Talk. We have 8 people so far, and number 9 is about to be inducted.
A new sheet.
As you're watching, yeah. See, okay, I want to show you. Although now they're on the website, so
that's right,
they are. But this was the old sheet, but you can see it was filled up. So I got another sheet. Are you going to make the announcement?
Go ahead.
No, you.
Well, it's my turn to pick.
So this is your pick.
I think this is a well-deserved. He's a loyal listener. He listens almost every time it's uploaded the same night. Comments and contributes all over the place.
And he's happy as hell to when I do my Would You Rather. Oh, he participates in that. I don't think he's missed a week. Mm-hmm. So, I think this is a good one.
Yep, it's Brian Cafaro.
Right there. There you see. So now he's forever on a yellow sheet, and he's on our website. If you want to go read all our living legends, they're right there.
I think I think he posted a picture with his shirt too, right? It's out there.
I think you're right. Yeah. So thank you, Brian. You're now a living legend. I'm sure your life will change so much because of this.
Lots of fluffing.
I know he would participate. Okay, I got a question for you.
Uh-oh.
I've read a lot about this both ways. You sleep with the TV on or off?
On.
On?
Usually, yeah.
Okay, and does that bother you at all?
It bothers Misty a lot, but no.
You like
it? It's one of those things. I've actually read articles that say that, you know, if you watch like the same thing, it'll help you put you to sleep.
And okay, when I was in college, I learned this from guys I went to college with. They played music all night.
Mm-hmm.
So I did that for years and years. Mm-hmm. And then I got married. Mm-hmm. And my wife hated that.
Mm-hmm.
So we started going with, but she likes the TV on.
Yeah.
This week I was sick, so we slept separately.
Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, it's pretty nice. I love it. It's pretty nice. It's pretty fucking nice. And then my TV broke.
Oh, boo.
Well, the TV didn't break. I was having a problem. I didn't know how to fix it. Turned out all I had to do was unplug it. But I didn't know that. So I went two nights without it. And I got to admit, I slept better.
Oh, really?
With it off. But then my wife actually unplugged it and put it back in. So there you go.
Mm-hmm.
So I had it on. This is two nights ago.
Yeah.
Apparently, the TV show Mom was on. I didn't really know that consciously. Mm. You know that show?
I don't think I do.
No? Huh. Okay. Well, anyway, here's the good news for you, sleeping with the TV on. I didn't do her, but I spooned with Anna Faris.
Oh, I know who she is.
Do you? Okay. Yeah. She stars in Mom.
Oh, okay.
And now the only reason I couldn't, we talked and we even talked. In my dream, we talked about why we should do this, and I had her on my side.
Good for
you. The problem is a lot of those other ladies were fucking there, too. So there were about five people in the room. But, me and Anna Faris, spoon. We were in the same bed spooning nice. All night. Yeah, nice. Yeah, it wasn't bad.
Okay,
wasn't
bad. Better than it being like Golden Girls or something. Where, you know,
right, and even that wouldn't be that bad.
You got to spoon with Depending B. Arthur. On
which one B. Arthur would be the worst.
She'd spoon you.
Yeah. I'd absolutely spoon with Betty White.
There you go.
Especially on the Golden Girls day. She wasn't bad. She didn't look bad. All right. On to the next. We have three more subjects to cover in this intro. How about that? I made a commitment to lose some weight.
Ooh.
Because I have a doctor appointment coming up in a couple months. I know he's going to bitch. So. Mm. And I had some trouble getting some pants that used to be very, very loose fitting. I barely got on.
Uh-oh. Is this the doctor with the hot secretary?
No. Boo. That's my eye doctor. I need to pour some shit in my eyes because I need to get back there, but I really don't have a reason. Because, I want to get back there.
Okay.
No, this doctor, I guess one or two I would do, but not saying much.
Consider the source.
Exactly. But to those of you out there trying to lose some weight, I empathize. It sucks. I even was fairly successful this week, but I just fucking hate it.
Yeah.
Like, I like to go, and when I'm hungry, eat what the fuck I want. Mm-hmm. And now I'm not doing that. And, I am drinking on this day, and then I'm going to talk about one other day this week. But for the most part, I'm not doing much drinking. Eating so little.
Oh, no.
And, I just hate it. I just hate it. So
do you think it'll affect your performance on the show?
Quite possibly. Yeah. Although so far it hasn't, has it? I've been pretty good. Although maybe they don't know who the fuck I am.
You could be hard to.
You don't recognize
incognito.
Me.
Incognito.
Here's who I. That's Tiny. I'm the Prince of Pittsburgh. They probably didn't fucking know that. Thanks for bringing that up. Mm-hmm. Thanks for bringing that up. Okay. But anyway, I empathize for anyone who's trying to lose weight. And don't send me suggestions. I know. Take less calories in than you're fucking.
Good
Lord. I know all that. And I've lost weight before.
Yeah.
It's kind of like W.C. Fields once said, don't tell me it's hard to quit drinking. It's easy. I've done it 1,000 times.
Well, we talked about know-it-alls off the air, and oh man, are the
weight loss
experts are everywhere.
Right, they are. They are, and I know how to do it. I just fucking hate it. I fucking hate it. So I have to make a decision whether I don't know whether I want to actually stick with this or fuck it. You know, I haven't decided yet.
Yeah.
Okay, let me go on to another thing that's not fucking good either. Sorry, people. I had to lay this on somebody. So last week, I spent over $900 on a new pump for my well.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. And I actually thought it was going to be more.
Man, you've had more water problems than anybody
else. I did. And actually, we had a pipes leaking too, and they were going to send me a whole – they were supposed to send me a whole damn estimate, and they didn't do it. But the guy just tightened some shit and – thank God that problem's gone away for now. I live in a house that's 150 years old, by the way. So shit goes wrong. I understand.
Mm-hmm. Then, do you remember when it was completed?
What?
Because you're old.
Oh, I get it. Okay. All right. He was being fucking clever.
I usually save those for Sully. Yeah. But, you know, not here.
Okay. Yeah. I wasn't ready. Where is it written where you have a fucking line? I didn't see that. Okay. Anyway, spent all that on the pump. Then this all happened this week. My wife comes in. I'm fucking in bed. She said, I heard this noise from stove and a poof and a bad, bad smell. I unplugged it. We need a new stove. What is that called? An oven stove?
Sure.
Range.
Yeah.
Fine. So I looked them up online and I said, whatever I think we should get, I might as well double that price. Cause that's what my wife's going to get. And sure as fuck, that costs us $2,200.
Oh,
so they bring it in on, see, when you're retired, you're the one who has to deal with all this shit. Like, I know about well pumps now. I know about plumbing now. Now I know about new stoves. And the guy was there, and he turned a burner on, and he said, I don't like the sound of that.
Uh-oh.
And believe it or not, I even heard it. I said, yeah, me neither. So he took some shit off the back, and then all of a sudden he does it again. And he says, oh, that's not from the stove. That's from your electricity, your receptacle box.
Oh, no.
So I will say one thing. My wife calls. I call and say, hey, things are fucked up here. She calls. She said, an electrician's coming tomorrow.
Wow.
Yeah. So he did come tomorrow, and he did, I think fixed the thing. He tightened up a bunch of wires. He said that was it, but who the fuck knows?
Yeah, right.
But and he didn't charge me quite as much as I thought, but this is just going on and on. This is a new shirt bought by me.
Ooh.
And I bought a lot more, and I know that's my fault, but that's just another fucking expense that's come into my end. And guess what, people? I haven't even told you about the worst one. I've told you about the well pump, the new oven, the new shirts, the new electrical receptacle box.
Yeah.
Here's a little tease. At my bitch, I'm going to give you the worst fucking one that I had this week. This fucking week is coming up.
Man.
Okay. So.
On top of being sick.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I was sick already. That's right. And okay. That segues fairly nicely into what we're doing here.
That's what I do.
You do. He gave me this fucking flu or whatever the fuck it is. You definitely
did. I refute that.
You definitely did. By the way, this mustache makes it tough for me to drink. but I'm doing it for you, the home viewer.
There you go.
So yeah, I haven't been drinking much because of the weight loss thing, but this day takes a pass. That's the way I look at it. Friday, we're doing this on Sunday. This past Friday, I went the opening day for the Pirates. And it's probably, I don't know if I've gone 30 some times. I don't know if this was the worst weather ever, but it was in the top fucking three. It was just miserable. I'm bedridden all fucking week, except to talk to the range guy and the receptacle box guy. And another guy I'm going to tell you about at bitch time. So I go down to ball game. I did it because my daughter and son-in-law got me a ticket. And I didn't want to fucking go. Parking is just fucking miserable on opening day.
Oh, yeah, God.
The lines were so long. I kind of went away. I didn't know. Went back up to the north side and parked on the street.
If you don't park right after rush hour, forget it.
Well, the game was at 4, but I was there at fucking noon.
Yeah.
But it's still, it was horrible. It was horrible.
I mean, morning rush hour. You pretty much got to go.
You're right. So I said, get out of bed to drink in this cold fucking weather. Yeah. I powered through. I made it till about the 8th inning, I think.
Okay.
But then it made me think about a story, and I want you and you to tell me if you would do the same here. This is 1970, opening day. I'm a 10th grader at North Allegheny, and they made it. So many people skip school for opening day. They said if you bring your ticket in and then you had to have a legitimate ride away from school, you were allowed to skip school.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay. So I have a ticket, and actually 10 of us did. We didn't have a legitimate ride out, but two taxi cabs came and picked us up. And, okay, I can't remember, 5 in one group, obviously, and 5 in the other. And 4 of the people in my taxi were good buddies of mine. And one guy we knew, but he wasn't quite in our social group. Okay. A decent guy, though. So we're driving now from Carson Middle School to Forbes Field.
Oof.
And the fare comes to about $21. But as we're getting closer to Oakland, the one guy I didn't know very well, we realized he thought that was per person as the fare box kept doing it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so you already gave me your answer. I don't know what your answer was. We had to make a decision. Hey, yeah, well, he paid for the whole fucking
F and A, yeah, no doubt.
Okay, no doubt for you.
Yeah.
So I'm going to think some of our people out there
have a higher moral.
I hope so.
A higher moral compass than
us. I hope so, but I did not. Yeah. And he paid for the whole thing. And then the poor guy, he had no money left. So his mother came and picked us up and drove us back to the North Hills.
That's a free ride both ways.
Hell
yeah.
Yeah. We all had money in our pockets to pay both ways.
Right.
But we decided now let's take advantage of the situation.
Hell yeah.
I'll admit, I didn't feel guilty when he paid it. I felt a little guilty when he called his mother to come down to Oakland in the middle of rush hour and then pick us up and take us back.
Know who your friends are. That's all. That's the lesson learned there. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So that is my, and this segues not very well, but a little bit. In our next segment, Tiny and I are going to talk about, most people brag about their sexual exploits, either at the prom or at homecoming. Us two have a different story. Ours aren't quite so good. So stay tuned for the next segment, and you're going to hear about some sorry-ass high school experiences. They call me Welcome back to Pittsburgh Dive Bar Talk, a podcast that has been banned in Russia six times. Hopefully not this week. We don't hate the Russians, most of them. But but they ban us. Yeah. We want to come into your homes, you know.
That's it.
Riskies, vodka, yeah. Okay. Anyway, this segment, most people talk about their high school exploits and how they've done so well at homecoming and proms. Mm. And Tiny and I are going to tell stories. I'll entitle this 0 for 7. 0 for 0 for 7 because, well, I hate to give away what's going to happen here, but nothing has, to tell you the truth. But we'll go with Tiny's stories first and then mine.
Yeah, so I'm 0 for 3 of the part of the 0 for 7. So
you're doing better than me.
That's two homecomings and a prom.
Okay.
Junior prom, it was one of those where I was friends with both. My friend from high school was trying to hook me up with someone, and I really didn't want to go, but it was one of those like, oh, you know, they were trying to play matchmaker. And
Were you not going to go at all?
No, I had no intention of going. No, I really, he was the only one that was going, and he was dating an underclassman. So they tried to hook me up with her one friend, and we went, and the girl's fine. I mean, you know, she was nice. But you know, clearly she wanted nothing to do with me, and I can't imagine I was, you know, I wasn't a catch or anything like that. So we went, and it was more like we were just their sidecars, you know, like we really didn't interact that much. And the dance came and went, and it was just okay. Thanks for, you know, it was fun. See you later.
Okay, so it's over.
That's it.
That's one over one.
Yeah. So then that was junior prom, now or junior homecoming. I'm sorry.
Right.
Junior prom, forget it.
You didn't even go?
No. I went fishing, I think, that weekend. Yeah, like, no. Because I actually got suspended my junior year from high school. That's a whole other story.
Okay.
Let's
save that.
Yeah, that's a whole other thing. So I was gone. So then senior year, homecoming. I went to homecoming and prom with the same girl.
Wow.
Yeah, senior year.
And we're still going to keep this 0 for record.
It's demo 0 for 2.
All right. Yeah.
So homecoming, you know, I mean, dude, I went to a small school. We played the game Friday night. We dressed like 23 kids. So, you know, we get our ass beat. We actually won, but like got my ass beat the game. The next day is the dance. We go to the dance, and you know, I'm not a social butterfly, but I'm even worse in one-on-one situation. So I did not handle myself, you know. It certainly wasn't about her. It was about being a senior and hanging out with friends and all that.
What
stuff.
Year was she?
She was 2 years younger, sophomore.
Oh, right. You're robbing the cradle.
Sure.
That might be against the law.
So the dance comes and goes. And again, I'm terrible at one-on-one. I still am. I can't, I could talk to the dog better than people, but so homecoming, the dance comes and goes. And you know, I'm certainly a no savant. And so we decide we're going back to a mutual friend's house. We're going to watch movies. And it's just there's four of us at the house. The parents weren't there. And I couldn't tell you. We put a movie on, and within 10 minutes, we're both sleeping on the couch, just out. You know, it was just, and it couldn't have been that late. I mean, how long does a date a dance go? Till what, 9 or 10?
And I was going to say 11.
Okay, even 11.
Maybe out here in West Middlesex, 9 or 10.
Either way. We fell asleep on the couch, and at like 1 a.m, the couple we were with woke us up. I'm like, hey guys, we're going to bed. So you can, you're welcome to stay, but we're going to bed. And so that was that homecoming.
That's two.
Yep. And then, senior prom, this is, you know, I never really thought anything was coming of any of this, but again, it's, you know, what's the wrestling adage, Saturday nights for the boys. I paid no attention to her at the dance. It was complete neglect on my part.
With the same girl you went to homecoming with. Why did you neglect her?
Because I'm an idiot. I'm not very
smart. I'll buy that.
And so the dance comes and goes, and I don't know. Like what do you do? I'm not a dancer. Like I it's not my setting. So I'm sure I screwed everything up. The closest I got was after the dance, we again went to somebody's house to hang out, and she changed out of her dress in the car. That was about as close as I got.
Wow.
Yeah, that was it.
Did you get at least a look-see?
I tried.
Yeah.
But it was dark, and I was, you know. Okay. Yeah, so that's as close as it ever got.
Really?
Was her changing her dress in the car.
So that's three.
That's 0 for 3.
That's 3. All right. See if we do any better with me.
I don't think we will.
And not looking good. At North Allegheny, we were a big school, so we had a different junior prom and senior prom. Mm-hmm. So you had to be from that class to be able to go.
Okay.
So I was dating a girl most of my junior year, and we broke up, and I had no thoughts of going to prom. Mm. And about 2 weeks before, this girl asked me, good-looking woman, good-looking girl, I don't know what you call that, junior year, said, hey, I broke up with my boyfriend. You want to go? Mm. And like I said, she was a good-looking woman. Mm-hmm. I said, yeah, let's do it. So that was 2 weeks before. The week before the prom, we went out.
This is a story that's been on before, isn't it?
Not this one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No,
okay.
No. Yeah, just keep your fucking mouth shut. No. We went out. We're probably in between segments I told you this story.
That's how this whole thing happened.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. We went out and we just discovered we didn't like each other at all. It was very mutual. I didn't like her and she didn't like me either. So yeah. I'm not going to act like, we didn't like each other. So we had already decided we were going. We go to the prom. We were having a miserable time.
Nice.
But, and this was my best shot. My best fucking shot, I thought. A girl came up to me and said, you having a good time with your date? I said, fuck no. Mm. She said, me either. She said, why don't we tail our dates? I'll tell mine I want to go home. You tell yours you want to go home. Come meet me at my house.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Movie game dance.
Yeah, and I liked this one.
Mm-hmm.
So we both did that. Unfortunately, I don't remember how this worked. Two of my friends found this out.
Oh, no.
So they both came to her house. So there's three guys and one chick, and I was hopeful. But one guy went to sleep right away. The other one just stayed up. And then finally, it was 5 a.m.
Oh.
And we had nothing left in us. So nothing happened.
Yeah.
Because that fuckhead, looking back, I should have said to him, will you fucking go to sleep or go to another room? Because I might have a shot here.
Yeah.
So anyway, it didn't happen. That's four. I won't go long on this one because this one I did tell on a previous episode. I was a senior, but like I said, we had different proms. But this junior asked me to go, and it was some girl that I had a huge crush on.
Mm.
And as it turned out, I was in a softball game a week earlier, and I almost got in a fight with a shortstop and second baseman. Yeah. And it turned out those were our brothers that were there at the house.
Such a good story.
Go back. I don't know what number that was. It is a real good story.
Yeah. It's early, like 14.
Yeah, yeah. But anyway, I just got drunk as shit.
Yeah.
And even though I love this girl, I really liked her a lot, but
yeah.
I just couldn't do it with her father and her brothers. Yeah. So that's five. I'm done. Senior prom. I'm a senior and I'm going with a senior. And a long story short, I really like this girl and she liked me, but not as much.
Mm.
I think she liked me as a friend. I was hoping it was
going to
be.
That's probably what was my issue too. I'm sure.
Yeah. I wanted to go further. And this woman even still watches once in a while.
Mm.
Noodle. Damn it. I still like her a lot.
Mm.
Great sense of humor. She's still, as old as we are, she's still a damn flight attendant.
Oh, wow.
And looks good.
Nice.
And looks really good.
Yeah, I'm sure.
But anyway,
you gotta pull that off.
But anyway, we had a good time, but there I had no chance. That's six. So I go away to college.
Wow.
I think I'm done with proms.
Okay? Yeah.
A friend of mine, actually, she's in the Living Legends of Pittsburgh Dive Bar Talk, calls me and said, hey, do you want to go to the prom with someone that you've never met, who's also a Living Legend at Pittsburgh Dive Bar Talk? You actually know this one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I said, yeah, okay. So back in those days, I think I had to thumb back. Hitchhiking was okay back then.
Right.
I thumb back. And it was a nice thing. It was a group thing we were going, but I did have to go over and pick her up.
Yeah.
And then we went in a big, this actually was pretty good. We went in a big, I'd call it an SUV, but it was bigger than that. I think there were five couples in there. And
like a conversion.
Someone was smart enough to put just married on the side. So we're drinking away in there, and cops are giving us the high five and stuff like that. Yeah, that was nice. That was nice.
There you go.
So we go to the prom, and we have a fine time. But I've never seen this girl before.
Mm.
And I took her home and just dropped her off. And yeah, we kissed goodbye, I'm sure.
Mm.
10 years later, I run into her. And I said, hey, you know, would you have spent the night with me had I sprung for a room?
Mm.
She said, yeah. I said, fuck. So anyway, that's seven. Oh, for fucking seven. Oof. Between the two of us, homecomings and proms. Mm. Rough time in our lives back then.
And look how we turned out now.
Perhaps that's why we're like we are. Maybe if one of you seven. Now you actually six.
Yeah, right. Because
you had the same girl. Yeah. Okay, my four were different. But just one of you six would have come through for us. Maybe would have been successful, debonair, suave, instead of fucking doing a podcast from a fucking garage with all these fucking goddamn Girl Scout cookies, the cathedral here, I can't smoke a cigar. That's going to be my bitch next week. So stay tuned. All right, we'll be back with Facts of the Week. Once again, we were way funnier off air just now than we were before. More people have to be. We don't have a live audience at all today. I thought we might have a couple, but no. Everyone that's been here before refused to come back. So we don't have a live audience. But yeah, we were just pretty fucking funny right there. But anyway, that's not going to take away from this segment. Don't you worry, because I got four facts of the week. I usually have three. Count them, four. And these are all conversation. So unfortunately, I'm going to ask for your input, which probably a big fucking mistake.
I think the fans like that, though.
You think so?
Yeah, I think they do.
Well, let us know. Let us know. I'm not too sure. All right. This is a British study.
Ooh.
It found that 10-year-olds that exhibit aggressive behavior on the playground go on to earn higher salaries in their adult life. And Amelia Del Bano said schools might want to reconsider discipline, basically saying it pays to be a bully.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I would be in favor of this, because by fourth, what, 10, so Tori's 10, she's in fourth grade. By fourth grade, I had been paddled in three different grades at that point. I've gotten in trouble.
Were you a bully?
I don't know if I was a bully. I was just a bad kid.
Yeah, I was kind of the same way. I wasn't a bully, but I've had my... I've had some wood put to my ass in the, that's not legal anymore, is it?
I don't think. No.
Okay. Uh-uh. Yeah. It's happened to me, and there was no way I was going to go home and say anything about it, because not only did I deserve it. Yeah. Oh, I'd have got my ass kicked.
My grandfather would have thumped me if he knew I got in trouble.
My father would have gone crazy too.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. This is number two. This isn't nearly as bad as the 0-for-7 we had before. We're both baseball fans. Mm. Seattle Mariners pitcher Logan Gilbert.
Mm.
He aligned himself with this online conspiracy.
Ooh.
That claims Wyoming does not exist. And he said, think about it. Have you ever met somebody from Wyoming? Nobody has. So my question for you is, have you ever met someone from Wyoming?
Wait a minute. Isn't that where Huey Lewis lives?
I don't know.
He's up there. Well, maybe it's, I don't know. I don't know that I don't know anybody personally.
I actually don't. And I used to run a basketball camp out west. But
yeah.
Someone must have come from Wyoming, but I can't really fucking remember. maybe it doesn't exist.
Hey.
See, I thought maybe you would have met some somebody at one of your damn concerts.
I have met a lot of people globally over
going shows. But not someone from Wyoming.
But nobody from Wyoming jumps out. No,
All right, then. I guess we can't say.
Can't confirm it.
Maybe Wyoming does not exist.
This I've never heard. I mean, you know, if you would have said like flat earthers and all those crazy people, but I've never heard the Wyoming one.
Well, I hope this is a tongue-in-cheek one, but who the fuck knows? Because until we started this podcast, I've never really done social media, and I'm finding out a lot of bullshit. Damn. Just to promote this thing. Yeah, there's a lot of... I don't know if people are being dickheads because they want to be, because they try to be, or is it just come natural to them? I don't know.
I'm a little from all three.
Okay. It's good to know. All right. Number three. A guy, a 68-year-old guy.
Mm. You think I'll make it to 68?
No. 68? How old are you?
47.
50. No way you make 50. No way you make 50. That's why you enjoy these damn things right now, people, because they're not going to go on forever. Yeah. But if you're watching in 2054, we're pretty fucking funny. We're dead, but we're pretty fucking funny.
You going to find a new co-host then?
Is that... No, I don't know. I don't know. I think maybe I'll be done too. And I'm not saying I'll make it.
Yeah.
I don't even know if I want to fucking make it. Laying in bed this week with the shit you gave me. Yeah. I thought about death a lot, actually.
Yeah.
All right. Let me get to my damn
phone. Okay. Yeah.
The 68-year-old guy complained about music venues keepers sending offers to let him perform his original songs. And he said, I'm a victim of cancel culture.
Oh.
So I started feeling a little bad for him, but there's one more fact here that I left out.
What's he sing?
It's John Hinkley Jr., the guy that shot Ronald Reagan.
But he had a tremendous singing voice.
How they let him out of jail, I don't fucking know.
I would love to hear his original works.
I'm sure they're fucking horrible, but maybe look them up. Whatever. They might be out there somewhere.
Yeah.
I did see a special on him one day. He's a horrible, ugly, fat fuck. And for those of you, just to fill it in, he shot Ronald Reagan to impress Jodie Foster.
That's right.
Yeah, and that turned her fucking gay.
Maybe we could give him our platform to come in and perform.
I'm sure he'd come. Who the fuck else is asking? I don't know if I want that asshole, but we'll think about it. We'll think about it. So, John Hinckley Jr., we'll consider your request. Maybe you can perform in the cathedral.
There you go.
How about that? Okay, and we touched on this about three episodes ago, but this year the Olympics, Summer Olympics, are going to be held in Paris.
Right.
It just became news that they have ordered and they're going to be delivered 300,000 condoms.
Yeah.
To the Olympic Village.
That's my kind of Olympic Village.
Okay. Now listen to this. I looked up. I did a little research.
Mm.
Basically, about 11,000 people are in Olympic Village.
That's awesome.
So, that's 27 each.
Nice.
27 condoms each. And if they're doing it with each other, you only need one.
Right.
So that's 54 per transgression.
Yeah.
Or whatever you want to call it.
Yeah,
that.
Yeah.
And okay, lesbians don't need a fucking condom. Mm. You know there must be some moral people.
Are there?
I don't know. Aren't there any Quakers that make the Olympics? not everyone's going to live there. Like, okay, the dream team from the NBA, they're not going to go live in some fucking dorm at the Olympic Village. They're staying in the nicest fucking – they're probably staying at the Eiffel Towers.
I don't know. I'd be I'd go for Lisa Sparks' record if I was in the Village. That's where I'd be going. Yeah.
Well, apparently other people are too.
Yeah.
That's a lot of fucking condoms.
That's a lot.
So I don't know. It must be the people to get eliminated early that just fucking go to town for.
I know. I think it's everybody.
You think it's everybody?
I think it's just a fucking smorgasbord.
Wow. You must be right. There's a lesson for all of us here. We should have worked harder.
That's right.
At our athletic, whatever.
See, if they would have told me that in high, hey, man, try. This is Olympic trials. It's everywhere.
Yeah.
Just go.
Tell us to work hard at sports. They don't tell us we're going to get laid by the most beautiful athletes in the damn world.
Seriously.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So you think about that when you tune into the Olympics this summer.
Right.
300,000 condoms.
Yeah.
Okay, that's enough for that. And we're going to come back with a movie and music game and see if Tiny can get three in a row.
It's a big week.
We love to go to our KO, Olympia,
favorite song. My favorite song. You're just in time for the movie and the music game. He participates. You participate. And even though you've had a bad year, now you're two in a row.
That's right.
What I do is I give you a character, and then another character, and then another character. And we get to six characters if you need it. And we'll see if you can guess the movie. And then I'll tell you some facts about the movie. And then we go to the music game, which is similar but not the same. Okay. So, is that a hit?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry, people. We're both Pirate fans. The game's on as we're recording this thing. And it's the bottom of the ninth, and making a run.
That's right.
They're making a run. You already know.
Hey, if anything is simulating what being at a dive bar, it's being distracted by what's on the fucking television.
Yeah. And I hope you survived the eclipse for that fucking matter, which I think there's a lot. Yeah, coming up here, there was so much traffic because they're all fucking going to Erie.
Yep.
What the fuck?
I know people from Philly going to Erie.
Seriously? Yep. Well, tomorrow I'm going to burn papers and smoke cigar during the eclipse. Because I figure no one's doing that, and I'm not allowed to smoke a cigar here, which you're going to hear about next week. All right, back to the movie game, although I'm going to keep looking up now.
Yeah, me too. Okay. That's okay.
All right. You may or may not. I don't know.
You said you were going to make this one harder.
It is harder, but I don't know if you'd have watched this or not. I don't think you're going to get it on number one. Augie. That's a great nickname, though.
That's a good nickname. Augie? Yeah.
Like people from Pittsburgh are named Augie. I don't know if do other towns have Augies.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, but they must, because this wasn't filmed in Pittsburgh. Mm. Okay, how about Mrs. Stimler? Not Stifler, Stimler.
Mm-mm.
How about Mr. Byright?
Oh, that sounds familiar.
So we got Augie, we got Mrs. Stimler, and we got Mr. Byright.
Mm-mm.
Walter Kornbluth.
Now that actually does ring a bell too.
Okay, now here come the two stars.
Go ahead.
Alan Bauer.
Oh boy, now I'm back to square one.
And the main star, actually Alan Bauer, and the main star. The main star only has one name, Madison.
Oof.
So just for those of you playing at home, Augie, Mrs. Stimler, Mr. Byright, Walter Kornbluth, Alan Bauer, and Madison.
Wow. That's like a clue version.
I
don't know this. I'm
I wouldn't have got it. I'll admit I'm not giving you any shit on this one.
Okay.
I wouldn't have got it. The movie is Splash.
Oh geez.
Have you seen it?
Is Tom Hanks? Is he and what's her name? Daryl Hannah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Wow. You know it pretty
I've
well.
Seen it, yeah. It's yeah.
Okay. Splash came out in 1984. You got two other movies around that same time frame. So that's why I figured I gave you that.
Okay.
And that's not the real reason. There was an article about it in People. This is the 40th anniversary, I think.
Oh, okay.
It just came out. So
yeah.
Go ahead.
Nah, just I saw it, but there's nothing memorable about it. It's I don't know. She was That was when he was in his string of shitty movies that people don't talk about. And
actually, he was kind of new at that time.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you. Here, first of all, it made $11 million. I'm sorry. Fuck, I'm fucking this up.
You're distracted.
It's partly because of the ball game.
Yeah.
And it's partly because of me drinking.
Yeah.
It cost $11 million to make, and it made $70
million,
which is pretty fucking good.
Mm-hmm.
Here's who the guys were thought for instead of Tom Hanks.
Hmm.
Chevy Chase, Dudley Moore, Bill Murray, John Travolta, and Michael Keaton.
Sheesh.
Those are pretty big people.
And that's all 84 for sure.
Yeah, and Michael Keaton only didn't do it because he was doing Mr. Mom at the same time.
Oh, okay.
And the rest turned it down, apparently.
Hmm.
Now, the women that were considered, even a bigger list.
Hmm.
PJ Souls, you probably don't know her. Mm. I think she was the blonde in Stripes.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But then everybody else, I think you'll know. Tatum O'Neill, Michelle Pfeiffer, Julia Louise Dreyfus,
mm-hmm.
Melanie Griffith, Diane Lane, Kathleen Turner, and Sharon Stone.
Wow.
Were all considered. I don't know why, but they were all considered.
I saw that.
Yeah, okay.
I would have out of those, I would have taken Tatum O'Neal, I think, would have been a good choice for that.
It would have. Although I'll tell you why Daryl Hannah was good that I read. She was a real good swimmer.
Oh, so she, I believe that.
She did all the – there was only one stunt that she didn't do.
Oh, wow.
Everything else was her. That's my first damn stunt. I guess I didn't have to say that. I was coming up. So that's true what I just said. How about that? The tail that they put on her was fully functional.
Oh, wow.
But real hard to get on and off. So, like, her feet would be bloody every day when they took the thing off.
Wouldn't you want to be the guy, though, helping her get...
Yes, I would.
I'd like to be... That's a good job.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, then you're really going to like this one. Much of the time, she was nude.
Nice.
Like, they put that on her, and they just had her hair come down, but they really... She was naked most of the time. And
yeah.
She said it was very uncomfortable for her because she really had never... This is hard to believe. She had never had a boyfriend up until that point.
Really?
So, yeah, that's what she said. She was like 22 or something like
that. Yeah. I could have been able to help transport her around when she had it on.
You could. And then, damn, I don't even think I put this in here. But I remember reading this. So it was so hard to get it on and off during lunch. She would just stay in the water with it on. And I swear to God, I read this twice. People would come by and like drop French fries down to her, like she was a real
art.
Yeah, exactly. And the other thing I just in her life, we gonna get a run here? He's safe. Yeah. Okay. Sorry, people, but we are
everybody's safe.
We are given a dive bar thing, and the Buccos just tied it in the bottom of the ninth.
Yes, they did. And the bases are still loaded.
Sacks full, and is there nobody out?
I can't see that far without my glasses.
Me either. But it must be.
I think so.
Okay. Anyway, Daryl Hannah dated JFK Jr.
Ugh.
You don't like him?
Yeah.
He was a good-looking dude, though.
That's why I don't like him.
All right. She dated Jackson Brown.
Okay.
She like it. He was pretty good-looking.
Yeah. Right?
And now she's married to Neil Young. It was the first person she married.
Okay.
I'm glad you said that. Thank you.
Really?
I thought JFK Jr., Jackson Brown,
and then him?
I know she's getting older, but damn. Yeah. Okay. We agree. Okay. Oof. That movie was Splash, came out in 1984. Now we're going to get to the music game.
Mm.
And it's been brought up that you maybe give me the music game, too. First of all, we're not the fucking game show network. For Christ's sakes, we're a podcast. One of these is plenty, probably too many.
Yeah.
Second, and this could be a bitch if you wanted me to. I had to listen to you brag for 4 years about how you were so fucking good at music and that you carried me and Sully.
That's a fact.
It's a fact that we came in eighth place out of nine.
No, I carried our team.
And the ninth place team left.
The only reason we didn't win is because I wouldn't dance with that stupid pedometer.
Yeah, well, you know.
I was watching the chick with her titties bounce next to me.
You know what you did? You fucking helped us when we didn't need it. And then when we needed it, the new songs... You say, oh, these are old songs. Those are the ones you fucking know.
No, they played songs by like fucking Pink. Who knows? You're gonna know Pink?
No.
Why the fuck am I supposed to know?
Well,
Pink?
That's what I'm saying. And
how is that my genre?
Well, I don't care. Anyway, I had to listen to you for 4 fucking years. No, we're going to do it my fucking
way. I could do a game right now off the top of my head with lyrics for a song for you.
You play a game on your fucking dick. Trying to watch the fucking ball game. Anyway, this one I didn't get out of my magazine. A viewer came up with it.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Jeff came up with this
okay.
one. Okay, you ready?
I'm ready.
I give him the lyrics and we see if he can get the song. And she said, "How are you, Harry?" I said, "How are you, Sue?"
Ooh.
You can take a second because I'm trying to watch the ball game.
Yeah.
Sorry, people.
I know that song.
Yeah, you claim you know every fucking thing.
Well, yeah, but then see, here's the other thing I think we need to do. We need to record out a sequence and record the music and movie game first, so I'm not drinking for 2 hours before we start. We need to record this first.
You don't have to drink.
No.
Well, I guess we kind of do, though. We're trying to, for you, the home viewer,
that
doesn't want to go to a shitty dive bar, we are giving you how it's like. We're watching the game.
Yeah.
We're distracted as fuck. No. We're not very fucking interesting. And that is a
double play ball. Oh, he threw it away.
Ball game, right?
That's got to be at least one base. That's it.
Is it the wrong inning?
It's only the eighth.
Oh, it's the eighth.
Whoops.
Sorry, people. Well, wait a minute.
Oh, no.
They're dancing.
It's over.
Yeah, we won. Okay.
We should stop while we're ahead.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. From here on in, we're not going to keep that TV on because I thought this was going to be a pretty good episode, and we just fucked it all up. I apologize.
The
Bucks
just fuck them.
Won. It was the ninth. I think we had the wrong score or something. I don't know. But anyway, we won.
Okay.
We won. Okay.
So anyway, I don't know the song.
You don't?
No.
Okay. It's Taxi.
Oh,
by Harry Chapin, 1972.
So again, another song before I was fucking born.
This was sent in by a viewer.
I'm
trying to keep it.
They're fucking old too then.
Once again, you just said if I did something by Pink, you wouldn't know what the fuck it was. What the fuck am I supposed to do? Would you be better if I did something by Diddy? If he's out of jail, I don't know where the fuck he's hiding right now.
Right.
No, that wouldn't help either. These were the songs that you claimed you fucking knew, that you carried the fucking team.
Yeah.
So, no.
I did.
Oh, go fuck yourself. Okay. Sorry. That was a movie and music fun game. Wait till you come up next, because I'm going to bitch about something.
Stop bitching. Do something.
This week, I had my taxes done by a preparer because I'm old. I get it done for free. For the 29th year in a row, I owe money. I guarantee I make less money than you, or almost anyone you know. I don't make any fucking money. Yet, when it comes income tax time, I owe. Listen, there's sales tax. There's gas tax. There's alcohol tax, tobacco, snacks, property tax, capital gains tax, gift tax, estate tax, and then vehicle registration, tollway charges, and pet licenses. They're really taxes too. I mean, what the fuck is going on here? Next year, I got a simple solution. I'll go in, I'll take a blank check, and whatever they ask for, I'll just write it out to them. Then I'll bend over, I'll spread wide, and they'll get the biggest fucking shovel handle and just stick it right up my fucking ass, because that's how I fucking feel when I pay my damn taxes every year, that I know rich people aren't paying, and I'm fucking paying. That's my bitch. All right, welcome back. This segment used to be F, Marry, and Kill, but I decided to get creative, and we changed it. We changed it to pour a bowl of chili on someone's head, play hopscotch with someone, have lunch with someone, but it has to be at Arby's with the beef and cheddar and the Arby's sauce, so it could get messy. Go up the St. Louis Arch with someone in an elevator. Once you got there, you were stranded for, I think, what, 3 or 4 hours?
It was something like that,
with Willie Nelson. So just the three of you. And then being stuck in a crawl space in Afghanistan where you were there and you had to be, you know, you had to stay in the crawl space for a few days.
It was, yeah. It was more than 4 hours. It was overnight
for sure. I think it was. I think it was. But then, of course, Tiny bitched like he always fucking does.
Yes.
So in this segment, you have those. We have five women, by the way. But F, Marry, Kill, you can use one of those, an F, a Marry, or a Kill, and replace any one of those five I just mentioned with these five women. And today is Amy Day. It's Amy Schumer. It's Amy Adams. It's Amy Smart. It's Amy Fisher, and it's Amy Robach. Mm. And did you know most of those people? I did give these to him earlier.
You did. Yeah, I had to confirm Amy Smart, who I was right about. And once I looked up Amy Robach, I knew who she was. I didn't know that was her name, but I know her story. Okay.
All right, so I'm going to let you go first. So it's Chili, Hopscotch, Arby's, Willie Nelson, Afghanistan.
Yep.
You can use those five, but you can eliminate one of those and put in the either F, Mary, Kill. So those of you playing at home, I hope you're thinking about what you want to do with those five Amys. As far as those, actually, you have eight options.
Right.
That's a lot of options.
Right.
All right, what do you got?
So the first, so if I did understand the rules correctly.
You did. That's unbelievable. Yeah. We'll see. We'll see. I bet you fucked this up.
No. I'm just like I'm flight of foot. My wits are about me.
And we should be a little better now. The game's over. So we're now totally interested in you, the home
That's
viewer.
Right. That's right. Okay. So the first thing I do is I take chili out.
Okay.
And I I am a toxic masculinity.
You want to kill someone?
No. I'm effing somebody.
Okay, I don't have a problem with that. But
last
week,
you
said you wanted to kill somebody.
Yeah, but I'd rather get laid than.
All right, I'm not saying it's a horrible decision.
Mm-hmm. No, I understand. Well, and maybe it's because who the people were that made it easier for me.
Who am I to criticize?
Yeah, these are your rules.
I never bitch. So okay, you're effing someone instead of pouring chili.
Yep.
Oh, so you're going to be a nice guy the whole way through here.
Sure.
Okay. All right. Okay.
So I'm going to get my notes here.
All right. Get your fucking notes.
Yeah. So then I'll start with F. Amy Adams. I'm effing Amy Adams.
Okay.
I remember her going back from like she was on The Office when it first came out, and I know she's gone on to do great things.
Yeah.
And she's a multi. She's been on the show a couple different times.
She has.
Yeah.
She has.
So that's
she may be on again.
Okay. Yeah. So that gets that out.
Okay.
So then next I'll take Hopscotch next.
Okay.
And that's Amy Smart.
Okay.
She seems the most normal of them all, wholesome. I'm going to take Hopscotch.
Okay. You can play Hopscotch.
I think I could take her too.
You think you beat her?
Yeah, I do. Again, I'm flight of foot.
You know, I forgot the right. They're all in their 40s except for Amy Robach's 51.
Oh, okay.
Just so you know.
I didn't know
you
that.
You think you could beat Amy Smart and Hopscotch?
I do.
Okay.
Yeah. I think I could take any of them in Hopscotch. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So then Arby's. I took Amy Schumer on this one.
Okay.
I kind of like her. I like her comedy and whatever, but she kind of changed over time. I didn't really have a good spot for her, but I'm putting her there.
Okay, and you're going to Arby's with her.
Yeah, I'm going to do Arby's with Amy.
All right.
Yep. She'd be a good one on, like, we talked about the desert island. I think you picked
I picked what was her name?
With the glasses from Saturday Night Live.
Yeah
she'd be a good one for that, too.
Okay.
But I picked her for Arby's. And then
I can't believe I can't remember her name. I'm getting drunk.
I can picture. Yeah, I know. It's
for you, the viewer. That's what I'm getting drunk for.
So,
not for me.
So then the Willie Nelson, I'm taking Amy Fisher.
Okay.
You know, after, you know, I think if we're up there stuck smoking weed with her, I think she'll stay low. She won't try to cut off my wiener or anything. And, you know, after all that stuff.
She didn't cut off a wiener. She shot the wife.
Oh, she shot the wife. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Okay. Her
but
too.
A fuco.
Yeah. But she did porn after she did that.
Okay. Okay.
I that look. All right. Either way, that was only a story because she's an East Coast.
Let me hold up my mustache while I have a beer.
I don't think if that happened in like Iowa, does anybody talk about her still? That's a New York thing.
Okay.
So I don't think she's going to get angry if we're up with Willie getting high. And then that leaves Amy Robach with the Afghanistan. Yeah. I didn't know that was her name, but I remember her story. And I'm hoping that, you know, if we're down in that bunker, that we get hit with an IED and just we get taken out because she's one of the, I don't know, she just comes across as one of those, like, she doesn't want to be a news reporter. She wants to be famous, and I think that's more important to her than doing anything.
You know her story. She got fired because she started fucking the guy she was working with.
Oh,
they both got fired.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. No, I think they're doing, I think they're real losers. I think they're doing a podcast now.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
all right. Well,
that's my list.
You're going to be happy to know we have none the same.
Good.
All right. Because I decided to, I decided, you know, I'm a nicer guy than you. I think it's. I decided to marry someone and then throw the hopscotch out.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So I'm going to marry Amy Adams.
Okay.
Everything I read about her, she's just like perfect. She's good looking. She's a nice woman. Mm. She's been with the same guy forever and
like
ever.
Like a female
and
ever. Me.
Yeah. Minus 315 pounds. Yeah. Same exact person. So anyway, yeah, I'm marrying Amy Adams in a minute. In a minute. So now, okay, I already took my one thing out, so now I got to go with the four other ones. Mm. Amy Schumer, I'm pouring chili on her head, and I'm not even helping. Yeah, very similar to you. I used to like her because she is funny,
right. But
she's become a fucking bitch.
Yeah,
so I considered using the kill on her, but I'm not that way. But yeah, I'm pouring the chili and not feeling bad about it and not trying for. In the past, I poured chili and then tried to console them. Mm. No, I'm pouring chili and getting the fuck out of there. Well, I hope it gets all over.
Yeah.
Amy Smart, I'm taking Arby's because I really don't know that much about her. Mm. I'd like to spend the time to get to know her because I think she's okay, but I really didn't know. When I looked up Famous Amy's, she was just one of the ones that was there, and I kind of knew who she was, and I kind of didn't. So we're going to own Arby's, and I'm going to spend some time to get to know her. Amy Fisher, I'm taking to Afghanistan. We're going to be in that crawl space. I'm going to mess with her for as long as I can't remember, 2-3 days. I'm turning her into the Taliban after that because she's a scary fucking bitch.
Yeah.
If she's going to shoot somebody's wife at their front door, I want no part. I want a part of her for a couple of days in the crawl space. I'll check her for weapons right away. So I know she's not going to kill me.
Right.
But then when we're done with our crawl space time, I'm calling the Taliban and said, it's her. Take her away. Which leaves me with Amy Roebuck. Mm. And I'm going up the elevator at the St. Louis Arch. And we're going to spend some time with Willie Nelson. Because like I said, she's kind of wild. Mm. And she left her husband for some guy that she worked with.
Yeah.
So I'm figuring, okay, Willie's 90, what, one now?
Yeah, something like that.
He's going to pass out. I'm like my buddy all those years ago when I thought I was going to get screwed in prom number one. Willie Nelson is going to pass out, and I'm going to mess with Amy Roebuck because I like the way she looks.
Okay.
So that's what we got. I hope you played along at home.
What did you take out? I'd be curious to hear what did you exchange in the categories?
I already fucking said that.
I'm talking to them.
Uh-oh, you're talking to them. So you're asking them. Are you thinking they're going to answer?
No. not based on historic precedent.
Well, I thought our last segment was the worst because we were watching the fucking game. But no, he might have just made this the worst. Anyway, we got one more sticking with us. We're up for Samurai Chatter. All right, welcome to Samurai Chatter. That's Tiny. I know you don't recognize me with this mustache, but I'm the Prince of Pittsburgh. Now, we have three questions today and a quote like we always end with. I think you're going to like the quote too, by the way.
Good.
Okay, should I guess get right to it? All right. Because
still coming back from earlier, so
because we are Dive Bar Talk, we have been drinking throughout, and it's for you, the home viewer. Like I said, you don't have to go to a dive bar and watch people pay attention to the TV or get real put up with fucking drunks. All you got to do is put your computer on or TV or whatever the fuck and watch us once in a while. That's all. Not that fucking tough. Anyway. Okay. And you can play along if you want. First question. Mm. And I gave him the first two. The third one I did not. If you could meet any author, who would it be and why?
Mm.
Yeah, do you even know any fucking authors?
I know a couple.
Really? When's the last time you fucking read?
I'm reading comics again, but
Are you? Okay. Yeah, all right. Stan Lee doesn't count.
He'd be a good one.
Oh, he'd be really. Actually, yeah. He does count if you want to do it.
No.
Stan Lee was. He was creative.
I'm going with the Bible. I want who wrote the Bible.
Wow.
Yeah. Because I think. Yeah, I want to ask the questions about all the stories because, you know, there's all that controversy about, you know, a lot of the Jesus stories are just variations of the Egyptian god Horus, you know, and is Jesus just a Hebrew Horus that they kind of spun into a thing or are they real stories?
You're kind of sobering me up here. Who did write the Bible?
I don't know.
No, I don't either.
Yeah.
No, that's...
I mean, we could even talk about Old Testament, New Testament.
No. We stay away from politics and religion.
Yeah.
And we're staying away.
I just want to know, listen, is it Hebrew Horus or is it all, you know, like what's the origins of all that stuff?
Wow.
Yeah.
That's either deeper or better and probably both than my answer. I went with Ernest Hemingway.
Oh, that'd be a good one.
Only because when I was down in Key West, I learned some shit about him. I went to the Hemingway Museum, and he would write from 6 a.m. till noon, and then he'd just get fucked up, whether it be in a bar or fishing or whatever.
Yeah.
So I would hook up with him at 12:01.
There you go.
I don't want to be any part of that writing bullshit.
Right.
But me and Ernest, we would hang out from 12:01.
The rest
he
of
wanted
the day.
To go out on his boat or in a bar. I could hang with both of those. And
there you go.
That's who I would be with. Okay.
Yeah.
Ready for question number two?
Let's do it.
Okay. What is the one thing you'll never do again?
Yeah. And I thought the easy answer would be get married because I kind of ride that a little bit on the show, you know, and I think it's too much of it's low hanging fruit. So, there isn't really, this isn't funny or anything, but I don't know.
No, nothing you say is funny. If you said something funny, it would be more popular.
I'm going with no more eye surgeries. I'm 0-2.
Oh, really?
I had LASIK done in 2000, and I had cataract surgery 2 years ago, and I didn't get it perfect either time. And it's not a problem. I can see okay, but it's not like where it's been like 100% corrective and fixed. So I'm not doing it anymore.
No wonder you couldn't help me out with the score while we were watching the game two segments ago. Then we fucked up really bad because we didn't know.
I'm LASIK and cataract, and I still got these to see with. So that's I'm done.
Okay. That's not bad.
Yeah.
I'm going to go. I had two answers also. I'm never going to shoplift. And
that's a good one.
Yeah, I mean, I did that way too often.
Yeah,
and I'm never gonna dine and dash. But let me give you. Okay, I've dined and dashed twice in my life.
Okay,
not one. They just. I even had a date, but they didn't come. Waiter, I had the money and the bill, and they didn't come.
Yeah.
But here's the second one, and I want you guys to. What would you do? And what would you do? I'm in Florida with a bunch of college people that I. Didn't go down there too, but ran into. And we went to a restaurant and we're talking good shit. And I love the waitress and all that. But then they all announced to me kind of, there were about 10 of us, that they were all going to, like 7 of them were going to leave.
Oh.
And I didn't have money to pay for the whole thing. I didn't have a credit card till I was in my 30s.
Okay.
So I liked the restaurant. I liked the waitresses, but I just couldn't. I couldn't afford to. I didn't have the money. I don't know what would happen. So I jumped in on it. Like I got the fuck out of there before half of them did because I knew they were doing it. What would you do? What would you do?
That's a tough one.
No, it was. It was. I felt real. The first one I didn't feel bad about because they weren't fucking. I wanted to give them my money and they weren't there.
No, that's,
it was like an Eaton Park. Yeah. But this one. Everybody was nice. Everyone treated us right.
And you're only fucking the waitress at that point, too. That's
exactly. Exactly. And I know I felt horrible leaving, but I just, in my mind, I had no choice. I had no fucking choice.
Yeah.
But I was not happy about it. I guess if I'd remember where the fuck I was, I could have sent him some money later on. But
yeah.
I can't remember where the fuck it was.
That's tough.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So I'm not going to do that again. If you're a waitress out there, you can
wait. We have a card now. You can charge it now.
That's right. I do. All right. One more question. And this came about, I was reading an article, and it had some of the top 500 rich people in the country. and there were like five of them locally.
Barlow.
What's that?
Barlow was one of them.
Barlow lives in Ohio. She would have been. She would have been in the top. But anyway, one of the ones was, her name's Maggie Hardy. She's worth $4.1 billion.
84 Lumber.
84 Lumber and Nemecolon.
Yeah.
And I looked her up, and she's not bad looking. She's in her 50s, I think 58. Mm-hmm. Not bad looking.
Yeah.
But then I thought, $4.1 billion. So now here's your question. When you were, say, 18, 19, 20, around in there, mm-hmm. and you found out someone had $4.1 billion, is there anything I could tell you that you would not marry them and spend the rest of your life with?
Wow. I have inside information on her because I have someone that I know that works there. She's fucking crazy.
Is she?
Like, legit crazy. Like,
but she don't look bad.
No.
I kind of like the way she looks.
Yeah.
Of course, $4.1 billion next to her name
makes
her fucking gorgeous.
Yeah.
But is there, let's, okay, you have inside info on her, but let's not make it about Maggie. That's where I came up with a question.
I get it.
But is there something out there? If you could make, if a person, man or woman, had $4.1 billion, is there something I could say when you were in your formative years, but legal to get married? Is there something I could say where you'd say, no, fuck it?
I don't think you can say that you could say whether it's a man or a woman that would matter. For that, you know.
Okay, yeah, so you're going to $4.1 billion.
Absolutely.
Okay, the only thing I could come up with is if I heard from a good source that they killed their spouses on a regular basis, I think $4.1 billion would be nice, but I'm not looking for that toward that death at 20 years old,
right?
So I think that's the only thing, though.
Yeah, that might be.
Well, what if she was? What about, okay, you said it doesn't even matter if it was a guy or a girl. All right, let's make it a guy then. Let's maybe make this worse. It's a guy that fucking smelled and was fucking bossy.
Yeah.
But, and you were going to have to live with him for like the next 50 years.
Well, at least 20 to make, I mean, if that's, you know, we're going back to the.
Oh, by the way, Miller, our beer man.
Yeah.
Who does work in law enforcement claims you don't have to wait that long. You're good. Ooh. Now.
Oh, am I?
Yeah, that's what he said. That's what he said. I was supposed to bring that up in the intro. Sorry, people. There was a ball game
there
on.
There was a ball game.
The fuck am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I'll call my attorney tomorrow.
Okay. Okay. So even if it was a smelly.
I don't know. The only thing that would really be a hang up for me is if they constantly, you know, wave their money in my face, like, you know,
yeah,
it's the only reason you're here kind of thing.
Like if they were a cigarette smoker, would that bother you?
That would be a hard one.
Really?
Cigarette smoke fucks with my stuff.
Okay. Yeah, see, like, that never bothered me.
Really?
No. You smoke, you poke. So I figured if I had a woman that had smoke on her breath, I had a pretty good shot at getting some later on.
That's fair.
I kind of smelled that smoke and kissing her and thinking,
there you go.
Okay. I'm going to town.
No, even like when we smoke cigars in here, it takes me 2 days to get back to normal.
Yeah, but we can't smoke cigars in here anymore.
Enough. It's
because
coming.
Because of all those damn other here, I'm doing this.
Yeah,
you can't fucking see that, can you? There's still a shitload of fucking. Can't you take a picture of these? Or you did it
I
once?
I think we posted it once.
Okay. Yeah. All right. My bad. Yeah. I think we're ready to be done.
Let's wrap it up.
Okay. This is a quote from George Raveling. Do you know him?
I don't think so.
He was a college basketball coach. And actually, when he did this quote, my brother coached under him for a year. And he's also the guy. Here's what he was a good basketball coach. And then he was an announcer. But he's best known probably because he has he was a makeshift bodyguard when Martin Luther King gave his I Have a Dream.
Wow.
And he was walking off and he handed George Raveling his notes.
Oh,
he has those note cards from the I Have a Dream.
Wow.
And I mean, he's been offered so much money, he's never given it up.
Damn.
Yeah.
Good for him.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, no, screw that. Cash in. Fuck that.
Well, I'm going to guess his kids, after he loses it, they're going to fucking cash in. But anyway, George Raveling, when he was the coach at Washington State, said, when the athletic director said I should recruit more whites to keep the folks in Pullman happy, I signed Rufus White and Willie White.
That's awesome.
That is awesome. That is awesome. Thanks for staying with us this whole time. I apologize. We'll be better next week. We're not going to put a ball game on next
week. I don't
week.
Apologize. Fuck them. Okay.
You old hamburg shoot. Bag you. We'll be back with episode 47. I think I'm right.
I think so.
Yeah, okay. Next week. Thanks for watching. Be the best. I am on a